I read this story this morning, Mike. And it's quite incredible. Whatever happened to tough on crime, tough on the causes of crime?
Yeah.
Because the last time I looked, criminals, known criminals, were a major cause of crime. So let's get tough on them. Let's deport them. Let's chase them down. Let's lock them up. If they've no right to be here, then get them out of the country. It's quite simple. I don't understand why Sir Softy is quite so keen on having criminals in our country. It's crazy.
Yeah, he doesn't like homegrown criminals, but he does like the foreign ones. I mean, that's what you get, really, isn't it? Don't forget, it was only a couple of weeks ago that we had the story of the Jamaican man who was supposed to be deported. Keir Starmer actually signed a letter along with various other virtue-signalling lovies to keep him in the country. And then he went on and killed somebody.
Well, the problem is, our homegrown criminals are probably racist and ideologically unsound, so
yes,
he'll be very much against them. But the imported ones he's very much in favour of because they fit with the woke agenda. They fit with the woke agenda. I don't understand, Mike, this hypocrisy around enforcing borders. I mean, all of these people, I bet you a pound to a penny that Sir Keir puts a lock on his door. Justin Welby has a lock on his door.
Yeah.
Gary Lineker has a lock on his door. These people understand boundaries. They understand the need for personal security. They understand the idea of ring-fencing their own property. But because they live out in the shires, where sort of illegal immigrants cannot just jump on a bus or walk past their front door, they're not bothered. They're not bothered. They don't give a toss about the people in Kent or the people in Rotherham or what have you, where criminals roaming our streets, illegal immigrants roaming our streets, who are known to be criminals. They don't care about that because in their gated communities, they're safe and sound. So security is something for them. But if other people try and apply security to our nation state,
yes,
for instance, then we are deemed to be horribly racist.
Yes. Well, I'll take that analogy even further, because what Gary Lineker proposes, and other people like him propose, is that whoever knocks on your front door, you just let them in. And you say, yeah, come in. Why don't you just stay? You know, how many of you? Oh, what, 25? Well, fine, in you come. I've only got two bedrooms, but, you know, 25 you could come in. Oh, another 25 tomorrow. Before you know who you are, you'll be standing in the house like this, you know, and you've got 600
exactly
people in there. And they're all fine. You don't even know who they are.
Even better. Even if you're a criminal, even better, because the Softy Keir's plan was to give everybody a mobile phone and to give them finance in order to help them stay in the UK. Look, we have a real problem, Mike. The law is being manipulated by clever people for ideological and political ends. That's entirely wrong. Now, I'm a big fan of the stage show Les Miserables.
Yes.
Now, but my sympathies are always with Javert, the police officer. You know, he was hunting down a criminal, and that was the right thing to do.
It was. The point is this as well, that here we have a situation where criminality is not really understood anymore by the kind of the lefty, lovey classes, because they don't really have to come up against it very often. But the idea that somehow, if you just say to everybody, well, they're basically good people, everybody's a good person. I mean, you wouldn't get very far walking the streets of London, I'm afraid.
No, you wouldn't, and that's why I say, Mike, these people who say that, they live in gated communities, they understand boundaries, they lock their door, Justin Welby locks his churches, Lambeth Palace is not a walk-through, drive-through sort of place, is it? He understands the need for security. But because these people live in this gated heaven, they can afford to be ideologically pure and tell the rest of us that we just have to operate a laissez-faire policy to absolutely anybody who comes across our path or comes to our borders. Well, absolute nonsense, Mike. We need the police to police, and we need to pick up criminals wherever they come from and either lock them up or throw them out.
Yes.
It's straightforward.
But the deportation process has become, as you say, completely and utterly overrun by people who are picking holes in the legislation, picking holes in what may be supplied from the ECHR over in Strasbourg, the European Court of Human Rights. The Home Office is saying they're going to make it more difficult for these last-minute interventions to actually happen. But it's Keir Starmer's speciality. You know, it's what he likes to do.
Exactly, because there's an awful lot of money in going to court for these people. The problem is, Mike, we are using the law. These people are using the law for a political purpose. Mm. There's supposed to be a separation of power. We let the politicians decide what's right and wrong in terms legally. We get the police to enforce it, and then we get the judiciary to decide who's right, because everybody's entitled to a defence.
Yeah.
But that we've somehow managed to blur the boundaries. So now we have the ridiculous situation where the police are doing the bidding of the government, where the judiciary are following the equal treatment bench book, which is written by wokest lunatics, and where politicians, who also happen to be lawyers, are using the judiciary and the police in order to achieve their political purposes. We need to have a root and branch reform, and we need to have a clear separation of powers.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right.